Hello, welcome to our channel for probability and statistics. In this video, we will talk about prediction interval of a future observation. So in this video, we will talk a type of confidence interval. And this confidence interval is related to if you want to predict a future observation. So this can be used in regression, for example. You have estimate the parameters and you want to make a prediction for future observation. Because each time you will get different observation in the prediction. So this is called the prediction interval. This also has a distribution, right? But here we just use a very simple case for you want to estimate a population mean first, and you have known the variance of a population. So in this case, which called you have unknown mean mu, but you have known the variance. So how to estimate, how to get a future observation? So first, you get a sample from this population, then take the sample average mean, right? So this average mean is a point, can be a point estimate of a future observation. But of course, future observation has variability. So we want to get the sampling distribution of a future observation. So in this form, the statistic called Z, which is a future observation minus the x bar sample average, then divided by square root of the summation of two terms. So these two terms is actually the variance of a future observation. So this variance combines of two parts. The first part, sigma square, which is the known variance of the population variance. And the second part is the sigma square divided by n is sampling means variance. So sampling means also have variance, but is very small compared with the population, because sampling mean average of the sample, the variance is sigma square divided by n. So your future observation, you have the variance larger than single sample from the population, because you have to add a part of the sample means variance here. Why? Because we do not know the true population mean value. We use the sample bar, sample average in estimating the future observation. So that's why we have to add extra variance to the population variance here to get this standardized value, say, which has standard normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation 1. So with mathematical manipulation, this is future prediction, and this lower bound and this upper bound will decide the confidence interval at 1 minus alpha level. So here, for example, alpha is 0.05 for the significant level. So 1 minus alpha is 0.95 for confidence. So we have the 95% confidence to say this future observation will stay between this lower bound and upper bound. And each bound is just the sample average which we get. Then minus the z half alpha for the z value times the sigma. We also know this is sigma, right? With no variance, just take a square root of the variance. Then times 1 plus 1 of n square root. And for the upper bound, just x bar plus this product. So we look at an example. Due to the decrease in interest rates, the First Citizens Bank received a lot of mortgage applications. A risk sample of 50 mortgage loans resulted in an average loan amount of $250,300. Assume a population standard deviation of $25,000. For the next customer who fills out a mortgage application, find a 95% prediction interval for the loan amount. So here we know the true population standard deviation, and we get the sample average of 50 sample. Then we have to find the 95% prediction interval for the future customer. So this is actually is a one future prediction interval. So here, sorry. So here we just fill in X bar and with a Z value 0.025 is 1.96 for standard normal distribution. So fill in these values in previous formula, we can get about the lower bound is 207,000 and upper bound is 306,000. This prediction interval for a future customer's mortgage scenario. Thanks for watching.